Good afternoon to all of viewers. You're watching the 230 Factor right here on NDTV Profit. It's a smart day straight, and you saw that recovery coming in sometime during mid-afternoon when the markets really started to pick up steam. 5381 now, once again, making its approach towards 5400 for no apparent reason, because again, today's session has proved to be a red line for the rupee, which is down about 1.6%. 65 plus on the currency, that's still holding there. Rand Baxi today has seen a big move of 20% after yesterday's 11% dip. This has come as a surprise, looking at the kind of a sharp up move the stock has seen, and the volumes have supported this move. So 396 now and moving up quickly for Rand Baxi, 65 odd points higher. This one is the biggest gainer on the Nifty. Lots of stocks actually are posting heavy gains, including the metals pack. So Sesa Goa is up about 10% plus right now, about 11% for Sesa Goa. Tata Steel is up 9.5%. That's a big day for Tata Steel as well. Hindalco is up 8% at 100. JP Associates is up 7%. That's trading at about 33. NMDC moves up 6.5%. Then you've got Reliance Infrastructure, which is up 5%. BPCL, ONGC from the oil and gas pack, up about 4.5% apiece. Cane India is also up about 4.25%. Other pharma names, Sun Pharma is up 4%, and even Dr. Reddy's for that matter today has given you a move of about 3.5%. So pharma as a pack is doing really well. Aside from that, a few losers as well. So amongst them, banks today are the sore spot once again. So there's no excitement, or this, this is not trickled into banks, the fall that we're seeing on the index. So IndusInd Bank, HDFC Limited, HDFC Bank, Axis Bank, ICICI Bank, State Bank of India, IDFC, they're all under in today's session. That's on the Nifty. Let's quickly look at what's happening in the broader market space as well. In the morning session, they were under by about 0.5%, but looking at the way the large cap index has picked up in the second half of trade, there has been some excitement even in the broader market. So 1% plus on the mid cap as well, on the BSE 500, but the BSE small cap and mid cap index seem to be flat at this point. So you've got a few names there. Just want to quickly run through the gainers. And we spoke about metals in the large cap space, but metals in the mid cap space also are exuberating the same amount of excitement. So Uttam Galva is up 10%. JSW Steel is up 9%. Hindustan Zinc is up 8.5%. So these are amongst the metal packs. SAIL, that's Steel Authority of India, is up another 6.25%. Jindal Saw is up 9%. So these are the mid-tier metals and mining names. Nalco is up 5.5%. Aside from that, a few other gainers are United Breweries Holdings up 2%, Syntex is up 2%, Cipla is up 2%, HOEC is up 2%, but the big gainers are obviously the metals. Losers then, you've got Yes Bank down 7% today. We've got Soba Developers 5% cut. Adani Ports is down 5%. Education stocks are under. So EduComp and Core EduTech down 5% apiece. M&M Financial Services also down 4.5%. A quick look at Europe. Yesterday's session was not all that great ahead of the FOMC minutes before they came out. Let's just quickly take a look at how the FTSE CAC as well as the DAX trading right now. So up 1.5% plus on IBEX 35, CAC 40 is trading up 1%, and so is the FTSE 100. So you're getting global support as well at this point. And a quick look at the rupee before we go across and bring in Shubham Agarwal to talk about his ideas. So the currency market right now, still dilly-dallying. You've got huge swings taking place on an intraday basis. For the sixth straight day in a row, we've lost more than 1% on the currency. 65.12 now, record low being hit in intraday trade yet again. Shubham Agarwal is here with us. Shubham, what's the market mood like? What are you telling clients?
Yeah, hi. If you look at the overall trend of Nifty, some time back, Nifty was holding on to the level of 5500 to 5550, which was a very important support for the index. But that support has, been taken out, and most of the analysis on the charts are suggesting us that the medium term trend has turned to be negative now. So we feel that these kind of a pullback will keep on happening. We saw a decent pullback coming in yesterday as well, but that was entirely negated. So the temporary pullback will keep on happening, but we expect that Nifty should find supply around the band of 5500 to 5550, which is an ideal level where one should look for a short selling opportunity. The stop loss for this view could be kept at around 5600, which is the stop loss that we are recommending. On the downside, the first target that we were looking for was 5250, which has been hit in the morning session. But once that level is taken out, which we are expecting it to happen, I think the Nifty is headed toward the level of 5030. So the view remains negative. Even if you look at the intermarket development, the volatility index have moved up, with which we have a negative correlation. Even the bond yields across the globe has been moving up, which is creating more risk for the system. So the view remains negative. The target for Nifty remains at 5030, and any pullback on Nifty should be used as a selling opportunity.
Okay. That was pretty much what happened in yesterday's session as well. We still got 1 hour left to go for trade, and whether or not we see the indices reversing intraday gains from here goes to be seen. Shubham, what's happening in the mid-cap space? It looks like today there's not much of a contribution that's coming in.
Right. If you look at the mid-cap index, that has been there in a downtrend before Nifty topped out. So we saw that the index made a top around 8800, and since then it has been falling down all the way to 6500 now. So even if we have to talk about levels for the mid-cap index, we feel that another 500-600 point, which is another 10% correction, is very much visible on the mid-cap space. So we are expecting that that remains to be an avoid, because this has been a relatively underperforming the broader market, and we don't feel that when the view on large caps are negative, then any mid cap will be able to do well. So even the mid cap space is negative, and we can see that most of the mid cap banks or any other mid cap stocks have broken down more than 40-50%, and even now this is just a temporary consolidation which has been taking place, and we expect that the second round of selling should happen in the mid cap space. So the index might halt around another 10% of a correction, but some of the specific stocks, the mid cap banking space can take a very big hit. So mid cap also remains an avoid at this point of time. I think there are some short selling opportunities that we see from that space. So some of the mid cap banks are actually looking very lucrative. Even if I have to name some of them, Allahabad Bank and Dena Bank are the two stocks which can be sold short.
All right, so watch out for the banks there. What's happening to Ranbaxy, Shubham? Any reason why you'd see so much interest in the company?
Yes, if we have to talk about the overall pharma space, then we feel that pharma and IT, these are the two sectors which can continue outperformance, because of the because people don't have other opportunities where they can get their investment at least at par. So yes, pharma remains positive, but talking specific about Ranbaxy, we are not confident about that stock looking at the behavior on the chart. Generally when the volatility seems to be very high for the stock, we generally avoid it. But if you look at the long-term trend of that, a very important support was placed around 390 to 400, which was taken out some time back, and this is a pullback that has taken place on that. So we expect that 400 to 410 should be a very strong resistance for Ranbaxy. And until and unless that level is taken out, we should not be looking for long opportunities. Only if the stock is able to clear that level, we might look for that. But for the time being, it remains in our avoid list.
Okay, that's Ranbaxy. Huge moves yesterday as well as today. Metals, since the last 3-4 trading sessions, they're where the interest lies. On firm ground right now, Tata Steel, all of them, JSW Steel, Hindalco, smaller names like Uttam Galva, Hindustan Zinc, everything's moving up. What's your take on it?
Yes, if we look at metals on a relative strength chart, then we can clearly see that the index has been underperforming Nifty for the last 3 years. And we don't have such evidence on chart based on which we can say that bottom has been formed. Every 6-7 months you see that a movement happens on these kind of a sector, where we see the index moving up by 15-20%, but ultimately it breaks down below the previous low. So that same mistake keeps on repeating every 6-8 months. So we expect that this is a very similar movement where the long term trend is down, but yes, we are witnessing a pullback because the sector is definitely heavily oversold. If one has to take a view for more than 3-4 months, I would take this pullback as a selling opportunity, because you know we don't see any kind of a bottom getting formed until and unless the sector shows a consolidation before it bottoms out, which has not happened till now. So I would wait for another 10-12% kind of a rally on the metal index. Once that happens, you know, stocks like Tata Steel and Sasa Goa will be the top two names. Where again we would be looking for some selling opportunities. Even on the mining space, Coal India has broken down from a very important support. I think it has a weightage of around 30% on the CNX metal, and that is also one stock which can be sold short for a target of 220.
Hmm. Anything else? Any specific stocks that you would like to talk about, Shubham, on your own?
Right. As we know that, you know, pharma and IT are the two sectors which can do well. Despite market falling down, so we recommend Dr. Reddy at this level. You know, the stock has already corrected, and today we have seen bullish engulfing pattern getting formed there. So we recommend buying Dr. Reddy for a target of 2350, and a stop loss can be kept at 1980. One more stock would be on the sell side. If you look at the CNX Energy Index, there was very important support around 7400, and the index was consolidating between the band of 7400 to 8300, but some 2-3 days back we saw that lower band of 7400 has been broken down. The index has pulled back today, but we feel that this breakdown has taken place should find support around 6800. So with that view, we are recommending to sell BPCL on this rally which is happening, and one can look for a target of 250 to 255, and a stop loss for the period can be kept at 350.
Got that. Shubham, thanks very much for that. Appreciate your time. That's Shubham Magarwal there with some of his stock ideas. Let's quickly take a look at some calls that are coming in on India.